Hey, what's up? John Sanmez from SimpleProgrammer.com. So I thought I'd answer this question today about sort of what do you do when you get stuck? Like, how do you come up with ideas, get to the next level? Sort of a long email. I'm gonna try to summarize some of it, but I'm gonna read a lot of it because I think this is important. And this email comes from Paul, and he says, I'll start with the basics about myself. I'm currently 14. So that's pretty cool. And I started programming about a year and a half ago, somewhat on and off. I started with Java, really just messing around with it, maybe 6 to 12 months ago. I started on a project that started off as a console application and found the prime factors of a number. I later upgraded the application, implementing it into a GUI, and throughout my free time, I've made some more minuscule updates to it. However, the program I'm really quite happy with is a custom scoreboard I created. So I'm going to skip a little ahead here, but he goes on to say basically that, you know, he's gone through these projects and he's advanced on these, but he says that that was longer than I thought it would be. Personally, I'm not sure what I should do next. I've really found the hardest part about programming so far is getting an idea, and this is what I want to hit on here. So he says, at the moment, I only know Java well with basic knowledge of HTML and CSS, but I'm planning on learning C++ throughout the year. I guess the whole point of this was to ask if you have any suggestions in general, how to get ideas or even which ideas to follow through on. Really, this was just the ramblings of a madman, but hey, if I get something out of that, it's even better. Thanks for reading, Paul. So Paul, you know, congratulations. I mean, you're only 14. You're already tackling some pretty complex stuff. This is, you're doing awesome. Like, don't feel like you're not living up to the level you need to be. You're way ahead. But that doesn't mean that you should rest on your laurels either. So I'm going to give you some advice to help move forward. And, you know, what I didn't read in your email, because it was fairly long, but what sort of came out was this idea of you've gotten so far, right, in your development, and you want to know, you said that the hardest part is coming up with ideas, so you want to know what should you do next, right? So how do you come up with new ideas in order to make new programs? You did, I think, a scoreboard, you said. You did a prime numbers program, so what do you do next? So really, and this is a common problem a lot of developers run into, is you want to separate this idea from coming up with an idea and practicing, right? And so you'll see this, I'm gonna give you kind of an analogy here. So you'll see this in the art world, right? Great artists steal. they don't reinvent the new thing. And the reason why is for a couple of reasons. One reason is because when you copy someone else's thing, you can practice the technique aside from the creativity. There's two sides of our brain, and in programming we sort of use both of these. One is the creative side, where we come up with the ideas, where we come up with new things, and one is the technique side, which is more analytical, where we're actually implementing, right? And so if you look at great artists, you know, anyone in that profession, a lot of times they copy first. That's how they learn. You look at, I did a video on Van Gogh Museum when I was there, and he was a copier, right? He copied a lot of artwork. I believe Rembrandt did as well. And a lot of artists, when they're developing their skill, they're not coming up with new pieces. They're copying the brush strokes, they're copying the scenes, they're painting the exact same picture someone else painted and trying to copy it as much as possible. And by doing that, they're developing their technique, right? And then once they have their technique solid, then they use their creativity and create new things. And you know, sometimes they play back and forth, but that's what you need to do. Is when you get stuck in software development, a lot of developers get to this point. They've come up with an idea. You did your prime number thing. You did some scoreboard thing. What do I do next? I can't advance my programming unless I have a new idea. Don't come up with a new idea. Instead, go and copy something. Find another application. Find the next level, more difficult thing, right? I did this video on learning, right? You can check this here on one of the problems. How do I learn complex topics, right? Programming topics. And in that video, I said, well, if you're trying to learn JavaScript, then copy like the Gmail app. Make your own clone of the Google Mail app and write that, because that's, you don't have to come up with the idea, right? See, and that's it'll simplify things. So really your next step forward from this point is to figure out something. What is the next level complicated program? Look for one that's already existing and then copy it and see how many applications. When you get to the point where you can take any application that someone's built and you can copy that and you can write that code, then you know that your technique is proficient enough that now you can go and create your own ideas. You don't want to be, you know, bounded by your own creativity. And also it will stall you out in the process, right? If you're creating while you're trying to develop technique, you get confused and you wonder if you're doing the best thing. It's better to just copy at first. You know, don't be afraid to steal. And then one other thing I'll give you here on top of that is you can make things better, right? So a lot of times someone will copy someone else's idea or program, and then they'll figure out as they're doing it ways to make it better, and then they develop their own version of that. Almost everything in the world, when you see it, there's very few things that are new, right? Everything is usually a copy of something that's been improved. So, you know, really that's the skill that you're going to need anyway. So anyway, congratulations on everything that you've done so far. Hope this helps you. And if you've got a question for me, email me at john@simpleprogram.com. And if you like this video, subscribe. Take care.